Hello, today I want to do a video two parts. First part, and maybe if I like it, I will do them more regularly. In the first part I talk about an upcoming release. Because you know, sometimes these things are quite limited, and after a period, sometimes short period of time, you can't get them anymore, or they are gone. And it takes years sometimes until they get repressed. So maybe I thought that it's quite interesting when I do stuff with acoustic sound series, tone poet classic series, other stuff where I say, okay, this comes then and then. I put down a link in the video description so that you don't miss any stuff you are interested in. I think in my case it would help because sometimes it also gets a bit overwhelming. In the second part we talk about a box set, Blue Note, Spirit and Time, beautiful one. We get into it after we talked about the upcoming limited important limited box set of Ornette Coleman, Blue Note Tone Poet. That's not so typical and important. I think the tone poets aren't limited. Okay, tell that to the people who wants to buy the Chet Baker things, but they get repressed. I think when they say that here comes an Ornette Coleman box set, limited edition, in your usual tone poet quality, that's big, that's special. First, Ornette Coleman, his six records on Blue Note, brilliant stuff. Six tone poets with the beautiful gatefolds, around $200, which is of course quite something, but this is a beautiful set. Stoughton cover, session photos, six albums, great. I was so happy when they announced it. Of course, remastered by Kevin Gray, of course pressed over at RTI due to the 28th of January 2022. It has been announced a week or two ago, but the idea of doing stuff like this just came yesterday, and so I'm starting with this one. I put a link down below. I think this is almost a must-have. I think it will be quite go strong. It will be gone very soon. I'm quite sure. So this is highly recommended. Of course, I haven't heard it, but I'm quite sure that this will be a beautiful one. Okay, skip part one with the upcoming editions. Hope you like it. Tell me your opinion in the comments below. Let's discuss this. If you don't disagree too heavily, I will do them now regularly. Okay, now for the box set I would love to talk about with you today. This is the second time that Blue Note does this kind of box set. Mine arrived on Friday. Beautiful Spirit and Time. We go through the content, we go through my first impression. Always let's start with the content. Great box set, great package, and you get this stuff inside. Let's go briefly through it. You get a record brush. Here is the record brush. Okay, finally I have one. Then you get a CD, yeah, and you get this card. Funny. Okay, we go quick through that. You get this. Can you see it? No, I have to do it this way. I hope. See, quite some funny stuff. Why not? Not bad. All the heroes from Blue Note on this card. But that's not Oh, give me a second here, please. Then you get a postcard with your number. This thing is limited to 2,000 editions. I got the number 1,236. Hope you dig it. Okay, we see, we see. Then you got lithographies. Beautiful stuff. I show them, of course, to you. You got this one. Mr. Bart Blakey, beautiful. And another one. Well, this is beautiful stuff. Well made, nicely done. Okay, that's that. Then you get two small booklets about the Spirit of Time sampler. Let's go through it briefly. Oops, oh, come on. This stuff, well made, really beautiful. The content of the box set is great. They really have done a great, great job. Then here you have the next booklet. Again, well, that of course, comic, great graphic novel. Ah, this is beautiful stuff. Well made, Blue Note. Then you get your Spirit of Time sampler in an extremely beautiful gatefold jacket. On the sampler you have on side A, I don't want to go. Do you want to go through all of them? You have Scanning Scott, Kendrick Scott, Oracle, Tony Elm, Chris Dave and the Drummets, Nate Smith, Eric Harland, Go-Go Pension, Tony Williams, and another Tony Williams. So I haven't heard this sampler, haven't gone into it, so I can't tell you much about the music or the quality of it. But I've been through the two other records. First, we have here Art Blakey, African, Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. And the Jazz Messengers are Lee Morgan on trumpet, Wayne Shorter on tenor saxophone, Walter Davis Jr. on the piano, Jamie Merritt on bass, Art Blakey on drums, Dizzy Reese on the congas. Fantastic. And this is quite interesting. Let's take the hype sticker. I hope I find him. Here we have him. Because on the first look you say, oh, it's like a classic release. But it isn't. The jacket quality with this furnish and tip on here is much better than the jackets on the classic series. We have them remastered from the original analog tapes from Kevin Gray, but other than on the classic series, it's supervised by Joe Harley. And the vinyl is pressed over at RTI and not over at Optimum. So quite some differences on this recording. Original recording, by the way, is from 1959. So you can't say this is in a way a classic series. It's not. It's not. Beautiful, great stuff. The vinyl, the sound on this one is outstanding. The sound is as good as on the last classic series, which has been, in my opinion, the best so far. Beautiful stuff. Interesting stuff. Great album. Well made. And with the second vinyl. And there's only one downside, which I will go into now. The second one is even more interesting in a way, because we are talking about Bobby Hutcherson patterns. Same procedure, Kevin Gray, supervised by Joe Harley, pressed over at RTI. And beautiful, beautiful jacket tip on. The original came out in 1980. 80. Yeah. We have here Bobby Hutcherson on the vibes, James Spaulding on alto saxophone and flute, Stanley Cowell on the piano, Reggie Workman on bass, Joe Chambers on drums. Gorgeous stuff. Gorgeous stuff. Fantastic album. I hope they make these two albums at least available as single editions. So the box set probably is sold out. I think go over to the Blue Note website. Maybe you are lucky. Fantastic. This really, really makes me happy, this box set. It's a bit pricey for two records and sampler, I agree, but the overall packaging is deluxe quality. The only thing which is not deluxe are those inner sleeves, although beautiful made. It's this paper stuff, and of course I really, really don't like it. I don't understand why they do it on a $200+ box set. That is, in my opinion, not okay. But the other stuff is either beautiful or outstanding. Happy to have it. That's it with part one and part two. Hope you liked it. And this week is one of those Blue Note weeks. So we have this box set, we have the four classic releases, we have the Art Blakey live release. So quite some Blue Note stuff coming this week. Hope you go through it with me. See you on the next one. Thank you for your time. Bye.